Well, here we are once again overlooking Hollywood, a town where a lot of things happen to a lot of fascinating people. And here's just one more example.
Remember Cinderella of Once Upon a Time? You know, the kid with the prince and the shoe. But let me tell you a story about an up-to-date Cinderella and her shoe and her prince. Her footprints, which are going to end up in the historic ground of this modern-day castle, known as Grauman's Chinese Theater in the heart of the Kingdom of Hollywood. Now, my fair lady of whom I speak is named Julie Andrews, of blue eyes and brown hair. And she's inscribed in the pages of movie history because Julie Andrews became Mary Poppins. And for this, she was honored as the best actress of the year. Then, as an encore, she became Maria von Trapp in one of the biggest pictures of them all, The Sound of Music. And so, the ceremonies of this day, which officially crown her as one of the queens of this fair city. Now, some people may remember Julie as Eliza Doolittle of My Fair Lady, or Lady Guinevere in Camelot, or Emily for the Americanization of the girl by that name. But whichever, Julie Andrews is known as one of the biggest stars of all time. And the little lady who comes from Walton-on-Thames in Merry Old is very talented, which was recognized at an early age when she became a professional entertainer at 12. She appeared in a revue at the London Hippodrome called Starlight Roof. But the Prince Charming by the name of success came when she was appearing at the London Palladium in, of all things, Cinderella. She was offered and reluctantly accepted a role on Broadway in the musical The Boyfriend. And very luckily, Julie demanded and was given a short contract. So when the Messrs. Lerner and Lowe discovered and wanted her for My Fair Lady, Julie was ready to accept. And fate walked with Julie hand in hand. For when the movie of My Fair Lady was to be made, another was chosen. And Julie became the award-winning, high-flying nanny by the name of Mary Poppins. And in the succeeding year, another nomination as again the best actress. Now she has the adulation of the millions of fans, so many of whom have come to see her sign her name and place her hand and footprints in this traditional ground where many, many years from now, people will look at it and say, once upon a time, there was a pretty little girl named Julie Andrews who lived in Beverly Hills. And what a fairy tale that's going to make. But for the people of today, they'll have their personal mementos and pictures and autographs. And they too can tell their children of the day they watched the real live movie princess. And some of them took rather unusual positions to do it. Well, my friends, Julie Andrews is the Cinderella story of the modern day. And when the clock strikes 12, midnight or noon, a royal coach doesn't turn into a pumpkin, but into a luxurious limousine. And as she slowly makes her way through the admiring fans, we can always hope that Fair Lady Julie Andrews will live happily ever after.
One happy girl, Julie Andrews.